we have to we withdraw from the world for some period so that we can spend this time reflect or investigate something, and after that we can return to our worldly life, our office, our work, and have more energy, more understanding, and can deal with any situation better. This is the meaning of the retreat. We have the retreat from making war, or retreat from some work. The word retreat means do not give up everything, but we try to prepare the new things, to start the new thing. This is the chance that we can observe or investigate that about our life. The people who knows see our way of life. Sometimes he say that it looks like we all crazy in this world. We run after some things. We do not know how to stop and how to contend with this life. We travel a lot. I stay in Suan Mo for many years and help some foreign friends. They travel along the around the world to search for something. If we ask them what they want to search for or to seek, they may say that they want to know themselves. So they travel around the world to know themselves. This is very funny. Anywhere you go, you take this self with you. You may hate someone or bow with something. So you start to search for new things outside. You change the atmosphere, the situation, the country, the culture. That gives you something new, but later you feel bored with it. Because you carry this self with you anytime, anywhere you go, anywhere you live, you still have this mind, this self. And perhaps this self is the problem. This self is the obstacle. If you do not really understand it, it causes you a problem. Now we don't need to travel. We don't need to go to anywhere else. Just sit and observe this mind, and we will journey or travel within our mind to see and to make ourselves known to us. To know ourselves is the most important thing. If you do not know yourself, you cannot control yourself. If you cannot control yourself, you will go mad or you will be crazy. So the word to come to the retreat, sometimes you can talk or you can understand it in this easy way, that to stop crazy for a while, to stop crazy for a period, to have the mind, the normal state of mind. And by this way, we will see things clearer. We will see things, we understand things in the correct way. And hopefully we may spend the rest of our life in the better way, with the understanding, with wisdom and love in our life. This is the main purpose to come to the retreat, to know yourself. What is benefit of to know yourself? Some of us come here because we have some problem. We do not contain much about our life. Some of us may have some trouble. So this period of meditation also good for you to try to solve your problem also. In the past, we used to think that problem or trouble come from other people. But now, and in the next 4 or 5 days, we will try to investigate, is it true or not? Or it is ourselves that caused the problem. It is ourselves that is the cause of our happiness or unhappiness. We will try to investigate this point. If we find that it is ourselves, our misunderstanding that creates happiness or unhappiness in our life, we will know how to overcome sufferings completely or entirely. This is a period that is very good to come here to investigate all of these things. In the past, we used to think a lot. When we look outside, we do not look within. But now we will try to look within. So I would like to suggest some guideline, give you some suggestion to stay here, so that you can success in your retreat, to understand your life, understand yourself, understand to know your body and mind, and success in control them. The first thing is that since we know we all concerned with the things outside, so in this period, if you can cut off or get it off all thinking about things outside, do not associate with the people. Just try to look within yourself, look in within your mind. This is the way that you will understand yourself more. So in these 4 or 5 days here, you should try to not to associate with the people. We don't need to talk or to speak with anyone. Just observe our thought, our talking to ourselves when we think. When we think, we talk to ourselves. Just observe these things. It will be good also if you stop reading. You stop talking and you stop reading. Because we read a lot, we know a lot. But now we will read the most important book. To read your mind, to read yourself is the most important thing. And read it from reality, not just from thinking, for speculation. You just observe it. This is a good thing to it can be help you also. If you read or if you think too much or if you talk a lot, it's very easy to go outside and forget your mind. Your mind will wander to somewhere else. When you sit and when you want to calm your mind, it will be very difficult. You must pay the price if you do not aware of this thing. When you come to sit, follow your breathing or calm your mind. If you do not talk or listen so much, it will be very easy because your mind do not so busy. This is a thing that really important. We all decided, we all make a decision that we will come here to know ourselves to spend full time for meditation. So please try to pretend or try to be the most happiest person in this world now. The happy people don't need to worry about anything. So we come here, please leave all the burdens of your work, your house, outside the monastery. Just try to learn how to be happy, how to have a happy mind, happy heart. And if you can have this experience in this 4 or 5 days, it will help you to know how to apply this in your daily life later. Keep in your mind that this 4 or 5 days is just a period for doing something. It sometimes seems to be not so productive in material or in your, not so productive in your work, in your job. But this is the best, the basis for your action, the basis for your activity. So we just try to make our body, our mind relax, clear and calm, so that we can ready to deal with the situation later, the situation outside. Don't need to long for the past that have passed away already. Don't need to worry about the future, because you can do nothing about the future. Just try to stay in the present moment. Try to be the most happiest person, the happiest person in this world. Learn how to be that person. Learn how to be free from all suffering. This is the purpose for us to come to the retreat. For this retreat, it is not just come and sit for meditation. It's also the period to listen to the Dhamma talk that will help you to reflect, to understand about the teaching of the Buddha. The Buddha teaches nothing besides our problem of life. We have sufferings, and so he teaches the suffering and the cause of suffering. And he also points how to quench suffering also. So we will talk about this in the retreat, so that you will have correct understanding and apply this in your daily life. Why we need to have Dhamma talk or Dhamma explanation? Because when you practice meditation in some retreat, they just ask you to sit and calm your mind. So if you just practice in this way, you can have calmness in your mind, but only calmness without understanding cannot help you so much, because you still have problem in this life. And when you have karma, you do not know how to go next, how to go in the next step. So we need to understand the map of our life also. And this will help you to understand the purpose of the meditation or the retreat. In this retreat, we organize many things that help you to practice meditation. We will give instruction about how to sit, how to walk, how to calm your body. And we know, from our experience, that we know that the Buddha also suggests that there's many methods to calm your mind. There's many things that support your meditation, such as to have Dhamma talk, to have chanting, and sometimes for reflection, sometimes for Dhamma discussion. This is something that will support your practice. So we organize the schedule for all of this activity. So please follow the all activities that we arrange. We have time for rest, time for practice, time for do your private, your personal things. So please do it with mindfulness. Peaceful and mindful, peacefully and mindfully. Don't need to be hurry, because if you hurry, it's very, very easy to get lost. It's very easy to lack of mindfulness. So you just keep your mind calm and be in time. Concentrate on the schedule. And I think you will get some or get good thing from each period in the schedule. We also have some friends who will come to join us in the evening. So in the evening we will have Dhamma talk that will beneficial for the people, our friends from outside, briefly. But in the daytime we have more time to practice and explain. So we would spend the daytime in instruct the method in detail, but in the evening we will just summarize or just brief explanation. So you are really lucky to come and join the retreat full time. And in the morning, we also have some chanting. This chanting we will use the Sonmo chanting book that is very popular in Thailand. We collect the Buddha word, the Buddha saying that will help you to live this life, and it also support our meditation retreat, meditation practice here. So in the morning we will chant in Thai style, and we will have chance to explain the meaning of the Buddha word in the daytime. But in the evening we will join with our friend from outside, so we will have chanting and some Dhamma talk, some practice together with them. This is the thing that I would like to introduce you to this retreat. So some of you may have some intention, some purpose. If you can let us know that how you come, why you come here, it will be helpful also. We are period for individual interview in the afternoon. So if you have any question about meditation. If you want to ask personally, privately, you can ask at the period of individual interview. Or if my explanation is not so clear, you can also ask me. We will prepare the paper for you, for all of you. You can write the question and then put it. Hand it to me or to the coordinator, so that you don't need to talk. If you want to keep silence, you can just write your question, and I will try to explain or answer your question later in the period of Dhamma talk or meditation instruction. If you have intention to keep silence, at the beginning it's a little bit difficult, because we do not used to that keeping silence. But if you can keep silence for a while, you see the very good benefits from that thing. And you love silence, because silence is very beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful things in this world. And silence can exist only when we keep quiet, when we try to let things go. Try not to interfere things. By this way, you know silence, not just only silence from outside, but silence in your mind. We come here, we practice sila or the good, the proper state of the calm body and word. But sometimes our mind do not calm enough. We need to have some technique to calm our mind. When you practice meditation, you will know yourself more because anything you think, you will observe. Sometimes you think the wholesome. Sometimes you think the wholesome thoughts. In the past, you do not know it. When you think, you speak. When you think, you act. But now, when you think, you will know it. Sometimes you understand that you are a very good person. But to come to the retreat is a chance to see your true face, your real self. Sometimes you see that your thinking, your habit is really ugly. You may find this. You may find this in your experience. You should be happy to see this and accept the truth, accept reality. From this point, you can, if you know it, you can change, you can develop it as successfully. If you do not know this, you will not start to develop it or to change it. You may deceive yourself, you may deceive some people and deceive yourself that you are something different from your what you really or you actually be. This is the goodness for this retreat. And some of you may use some technique before. You may use the rising and falling technique. Some of you may use the Dhammakaya technique. Just keep all of that thing. And you just leave it. This is the past experience. If you want to come here to know new things, to learn more experience, you should empty your mind. Do not attach to your habit. Do not attach to your own things. Just try to experience the new things. If I suggest or if we suggest you to do something new, just try it correctly, try to do it correctly. You will learn something. If you do not use the new method, you do not learn anything new. You just still do your practice. That's okay, but you should give yourself a chance to learn new things so that you can understand the new thing properly, correctly. If you just listen but you do not try to practice, you will not understand it correctly. If you understand it correctly, you can compare the old and the new one. But if you do not know the new one correctly, you can't compare it. If you misunderstand the new thing and you compare with the old thing, I think it's not so good. And also, if you practice the new thing, you will gain some good point of that thing, and you can apply it in your practice, in your daily life, or in your technique that you practiced before. So please empty your mind. If you do not empty your mind, you will be like this glass of water. If this glass of water is full already, you put some more tea. All the tea will go out because this glass is not empty. So we need to have the empty mind, free from all concept and habit. Do not attach to anything in the past. If you attach to the concept or the thing, the habit, you are not ready to get the new things. And sometimes, if this glass is broken, there's some hole at the bottom of this glass. It cannot keep the water also. So please pay attention to the Dhamma talk and pay attention to your practice. If you do not pay attention, you cannot understand thing also. Even though you get many much information or you can get, you can observe many experience. But if you not, without intention, concentration, the mind cannot keep, receive anything. When receive, it will go. It will not be with you. So please pay attention to all things that you do here. More than that, if we turn this gas down, instead of this, you just turn the bottom up. Can you imagine that it's possible to put the water in this gas? It's impossible. This is the same as our mind. If our mind full of concept, anything you hear, you do not hear properly. You do not listen to that thing properly. But you have the argument all the time. So any new thing cannot go in the glass or in the cup, because the cup is turned down. By this way, you get nothing. And if you give the pure water in the glass, you know, you put the pure water in the glass, but this glass is not clean. What will happen? The water will become impure, right? So to have calm mind is also very important. If you have calm mind, the thing that you will get will be collect, will not be polluted by your delusion. This is the important to come here. When you do something with intention, pay attention to that thing. You just do in the middle way. You pay attention, but relax. Don't be so serious, too much serious. Do not expect something from this retreat. If you expect too much, your expectation will become obstacle of your practice. You may expect that you will know yourself entirely. You may expect that you will gain Nibbana or enlightenment in these 5 days. It may possible or impossible, but your expectation will become obstacle. It's very difficult to be calm if you attach to some hope or expectation. So it will be better if you just listen, pay attention, and try to do, try to follow the advice correctly. If you do the method correctly, the result or the fruit will come naturally. You don't need to hope for it. If you expect or hope for something, it's very easy to disappoint it, and you will gain frustration. Sometimes you get many things, but you expect something, but you miss it, you do not get it. So this expectation make you suffer. And you still cling with this expectation, so you do not see what you get. You only see what you do not get, and this you make you unhappy. So to try to be the most happy people, the happiest person in the world, is to live with no expectation. You just live with your wisdom, mindfulness, understanding. This is better than to live with hope and expectation. So learn to live in this way, and you will not have frustration or disappointment from your your retreat or your action, your activities. So now I would like to summarize some of our retreat. The first one, try to look within. Try to keep your mind with your body. Try to put your body in your mind. You don't need to take anything outside. Your work, your job, your family, or even the problem of the world. Now, you need to understand the best you can about your body, your mind. So just to look at your body and your mind. This is the first thing that we need to try. So no talking, no reading. Will help you to look within. We have so much information to tell you. So don't worry that you will have plenty of time, or you will not get some information. We have much information to give you, and you can read anytime you want outside after you finish the retreat. And in fact, we read a lot in the past. But sometimes it do not help us to understand or control ourselves enough. If you do not talk or do not read so much in this period, it will help you to calm your mind. When you come and sit and practice, you will progress more than the person who still keep thinking, talking, and do what they want to do. The second thing is to not try to understand. Try to get the new thing correctly from our retreat, our instruction. Because if you attach to the old thing, the old method, you will not understand the new things correctly. And you may practice in the wrong way. And if some bad result, some side effect happen, sometimes we do not know what you practice, so we cannot help you. But if you follow the instruction strictly or correctly, I think there's no problem, because the anapanasati or the method that we will calm our mind is really simple, nothing harm or dangerous. And just have attention, but don't be so serious. Don't have expectation, too much expectation in this retreat. This will help you to be easy, more easy in this retreat also. This is the thing that we would like to suggest you. And please come to attain the schedule or the program that we arrange for this retreat in time. This is the thing that we ask you to do. Any question about this? So that we will. About meditation. We use the method we call anapanasati, mindfulness with breathing. In this practice, this kind of practice, we have both samatha to calm down your mind and vipassana to see things clearly. So samatha and vipassana is together in this anapanasati. Uh-huh. People think that vipassana is the form or the method to practice something. But in fact, the essence of vipassana is to see things clearly, to see the characteristic of things, to see impermanence, to see things created that is not self, cannot attached. This is the thing that we will get from anapanasati. And this is also vipassana. The purpose or the goals of meditation is to gain vipassana. If you have no question, I would like to go a little bit further about meditation. Meditation is to, I don't know the meaning of meditation in English, but I would like to come back to our Pali term. The Buddha used the word Bhavana, that means development, or to cultivate your mind, to give your mind food, try to nurturing your mind, cultivate your mind. Sometimes we call this Bhavana, Chitta Bhavana, as the mental cultivation, try to help your mind gain calmness, clearness, and coolness. This is we call Vipassana. And in this retreat, we use the mindfulness with breathing. There's some reason. The first one is that this is comfortable or convenient because we have the breath with us already. We don't need to use anything outside. We have the breath with us all the time, anywhere we go. So you can practice. It's convenient or comfortable. And by this method, you can practice both Vipassamatha and Vipassana. You can calm your body, you can calm your mind at the beginning by the breath. And you can also observe things, see things clearly, that's which we can, which we call Vipassana. By this technique, you don't need to change the method. In some technique, I think it gives you just only samatha, or you just calm your mind. For example, when you recite the mantra, some mantra, putto, or you just watch the sun or the candle, the flame of the candle, the flame of the fire. If you observe this continually, it may make your mind calm. But or you can visualize something. If you do this, only do this, you may got some samatha or some concentration. But if you want to practice more, you want to practice Vipassana, you may need to change the method. But if you practice mindfulness with breathing, you can observe, you can calm your mind and observe and practice Vipassana or insight meditation at the same time. This is also very good. And the breath that we practice now here is really helpful to your body. It makes you healthy. It do not make your body difficult or if you compare to the technique of watching the fire, the flame of the fire, this will make your eyes really, really difficult. Someone watch at the sun, you may gain some power, some concentration, but this is very, very dangerous for your eyes. But if you practice meditation, your body will be happy, your mind will be happy, and your eyes also easy. In this way, it's a peaceful method, calm and clear. And there is no danger from this technique. In some technique, if you practice, for example, you contemplate on the dead body, you contemplate on the clock, sometimes you get fear or sometimes you are frightened. And it's also very difficult to find the dead body. You need to go to the hospital or go to the graveyard. So it's not convenient, and sometimes it's very dangerous because when you misunderstand, you may do something wrong. In the Buddha time, the Buddha used to stay the monk to contemplate on the death. And after that, some monk commit suicide. Some monk asked someone to kill him because he feel that this body is not so beautiful. So by this way, they misunderstand. The problem is not our body, but the problem is about our mind. But they misunderstand, so they commit suicide or they try to destroy this self, this body. And anapanasati or mindfulness breathing is the the method that the Buddha himself practiced. He practiced anapanasati when he was a child, just 7 years old. And he enlightened because anapanasati. And when he teach, he suggests that also, when he enlightened also, he lived with anapanasati. He passed away, when he passed away, he practiced anapanasati. And he also suggests that to practice anapanasati. Without anapanasati, our mind and our body will check, will not be easy. So if you want to stay, to live peacefully, relax, he suggests the method of anapanasati or mindfulness breathing. By this way, we use the technique, this technique, because this technique was taught in the Tripitaka or in the scripture. We use Anapanasati Sutra, or the sutra concerning the breathing in and out, as the Buddha teaches us. When you practice this Anapanasati, the Buddha said that you will success in your Satipatthana, the four foundation of mindfulness. You practice perfectly. If you practice anapanasati successfully, and the seven factor of enlightenment will fulfill also if you success in practice anapanasati. And the highest thing that we can get or can achieve is that to attain the end of suffering, the end of selfishness. This is also we will gain from anapanasati. So we use this method, use this kind of meditation, because that many good result, many good benefit thing. And also, if you practice anapanasati, you can notice that your mind, your body will be healthy. Your blood pressure, your heart, your tension will reduce. Some of meditative master, when he was sick, he can heal themselves by this kind of meditation. Sometimes they need to have surgery, and they don't have anything to reduce bodily pain. They use anapanasati to separate the feeling of the body and your mind. You can do this if you practice, and if you know and control the breath properly. Only one breathing can beat away all bad emotion. Do you have any burden, any evil thoughts in your mind? Only one breath that you take will get it off everything in your mind. This is the good beneficial that the Buddha suggests us to do. So we will use this technique in practice here. The mindfulness breathing is not mean that to observe the breath only. It means that to be mindful every time you're breathing in and breathing out. That means you be mindful or be alert, be awake all the time. We can observe more than the breath. We can observe the feeling. We can observe our mind. We can observe the truth every time we breathe in and out. The Buddha says the one who know themselves, who know himself or herself every time they breathe in and out, as the one who are not scared. Some monks said that they reflect every day about the death. Some said that they reflect every day when they have meal 2 or 3 times a day. Some reflect every time they wear the dress, their robe. So many times they reflect about death. But the Buddha praised the one who reflect about impermanence every time they're breathing in and out, because this one has mindfulness all the time. So we come here to practice mindfulness by using the breath as a tool. So at the beginning, we need to know the breath in all angle. We will calm our body, our mind with the breath. So we need to know this. So at the beginning, we need to know the breath in all angle. We will calm our body, our mind with the breath. So we need to know this and control it. The first part of anapanasati is to calm your mind. If you succeed in doing this, you use the calm mind to observe things clearly, to practice vipassana or insight. This is the if the mind gain wisdom, it will know the mind. This mind will know and will not make a mistake anymore. Not make a mistake again. And by this way, we will not cause or gain suffering. What is the cause of suffering? Now we come to the very important point. Every day we hear the people sick and die, but we do not suffer. Why? But when people tell you that you get cancer, you will die in 6 months, or you feel pain, you yourself feel pain, now you feel suffer. What is different between the pain of other people and the pain of yourself? If you reflect in this way, you may have some question. There's the same question as the Prince Siddhartha gets. When he travel in the market, in the city, and he see someone get sick, get old, and pass away, and die. This is really ugly, but when he knows that he himself, his wife and his son, and everyone, including himself, must get this also. He want to get this thing, and he wants all the people get this thing. This make him feel suffer. He feels suffering, not suffering of the body, but suffering of the mind. That the mind will get something that we don't want. We must stay in the state of mind, in the state of that we don't want to get or want to stay with it. This makes us suffer. And sometimes we want to get something. We cannot get it. This also makes us suffer. So the want or the craving, the expectation is the problem. This is the thing that we can observe. How they want arise, how our want, our desire, our craving arise, and how we attach to that craving. We do not, in the past, we do not observe these things clearly. Now we come here to practice meditation. We will try to understand this. Why we are selfish, why we have great hatred and delusion. And all of this make us suffer. Anytime you have anger, anytime you have greed, anytime you have delusion in your mind, just observe your mind. There's some heat or some pain in your mind. And this pain, this feeling, will push you to do something, to perform action, to perform karma. And you cannot aim or quench the karma. You cannot control this because of the influence of the the defilement or the kilesa. But the kilesa or defilement do not exist all the time. Sometimes our mind free from defilement. Sometimes our mind are cool, are free. But how kilesa or defilement arise in our mind, control our mind, and make our mind unhappy, and we become selfish, and harm ourselves, harm other people. This is the thing that we need to study, we need to investigate. And by practice meditation, we understand this more from our experience. We don't need to believe anyone who tell you, but just observe your mind. From when you have the calm mind, you just observe this thing that happened. If you want to quench the fire, you cannot quench it anywhere else. You must quench it at the place that is fire happen. When you want to quench suffering in your mind, it is the mind that you must observe, and you can quench suffering at that place at your mind. So just observe the cause of your suffering, the cause of your kilesa. Because you should know, at the beginning or originally, this mind has no defilement. This mind is pure. This mind is peaceful. But why? Why it become hot? Why it become suffer? Unhappy? This is the thing that we come to study. Our purpose to practice meditation is to get rid of defilement, get rid of selfishness, get rid of dukkha. Please set this in your mind. If you do not keep this goal in your mind, you may get lost. Because on the way of meditation practice, sometimes you gain some good thing. Your mind will be more powerful. Your mind will have some exciting experience. And this may lead you you may attach to all of these things. And if you attach, you will not progress and you will not success in your practice. If you still have kilesa or selfishness and you have more power, this also makes you more dangerous, more you can use your powerful mind doing something as you like. If you are a selfish person, you can use it selfishly to satisfy your craving. But if you set your mind, set your goals correctly, to practice meditation, to know things, to understand things, and to get rid of selfishness, get rid of your suffering. By this way, the way to practice is move to freedom, move to happiness, the real happiness. Move to liberation. We can gain many things from meditation, such as happiness. When you have calm mind, you gain happiness from the inner happiness. You can gain this every time you practice meditation. And this kind of happiness is better than any other happiness in the world. And please do not attach to this happiness. If you still attach to this happiness, you will not go nowhere. So the Buddha teaches us to be beyond happiness. This is the goal of our practice. But you need to have this inner happiness first and see the truth of this inner happiness and then let it go and all free your mind from it. And this is our way of practice. You can gain some wonderful things, such as your sense organ will be more refined. You can hear, you can see things clearer. You can see things of the world more beautiful than you ever been. You ever have experience. You can see things different from the person who do not practice meditation. The one who has mindfulness, you see things more than the person who lack of mindfulness. You will see something that the person who do not practice cannot see. We can hear something that the person who do not practice cannot hear. This is also we gain from meditation. When you practice meditation, you develop mindfulness. If your mindfulness develop, you can use it in your work, in your life. What you perform with mindfulness, you will not make any mistake in your job. If you do something without mindfulness, you will be easily make a mistake, and we make a mistake many times a day. So if you practice meditation just to apply to your work, that's also useful. But not just for your work, but for your the whole life of for your action, for your work also. And the highest thing is to gain wisdom. If you gain right understanding from meditation, this will lead you to end suffering. So this is our purpose. We come here to practice sila, to have the calm body, so that we can have calm mind. We stay in the calm, in the quiet place, quiet body, so that we can have calm mind, free from thinking. And with this calm mind, we need to have need to gain the correct understanding, and we will be free from ignorance. Ignorance is the last thing that we will is the first and the last thing that we need to know and overcome it. This is our course of practice meditation. So please keep in your mind in this way. And practice anapanasati. You can practice this and apply in your daily life, because you can practice in any posture. You can sit, you can walk, you can stand, or you can lie and practice anapanasati. And if you have mindfulness, you can apply this to your work also. You can open your eye or close your eye and practice meditation. Because you have the breath with you, you cannot forget it. You don't need to attach or to cling with any form of practice. But in this retreat, we need to have some formal practice, so that you can have skillful, and then you can use this skill in your daily life. You can apply it. Now this is why we choose the anapanasati or mindfulness breathing as our technique. Now I would like to explain a little bit about how to practice. But I think that we should have some time to change our posture, so that we can reduce your painful feelings, and after that we can use about 3 or 5 minutes to relax, stretch your body, and then come to listen again. Thank you. Be back for 5 minutes. Sitting manner, the sitting posture. Because we can practice meditation in any posture, but the sitting posture is the best one, because when you sit, you have balanced position and also relaxed, and it's more calm than walk. Or if you practice by lying, it's very very easy to fall asleep and then sleep. So the Buddha suggests the sitting. If you can choose the place, just in the forest, in the quiet place, that's good. But if you cannot choose the place, you just practice. You can practice also in somewhere that proper, or in somewhere that you can the best you can find. do not attach to the place also. But if you begin with the quiet place, and the second thing that you should know is to prepare your body. Prepare your body means to eat or to sleep properly. Do not eat too much, because if you eat too much, it's very easy to fall asleep, and you will be very difficult to concentrate your mind. Your desk is also proper, because if your desk so tight, it's not so easy for you to breathe and relax. So we need to have the proper preparation. The next thing is to prepare your posture. Now we start with the sitting posture. You can cross your leg. If it's possible, cross your leg. We have the three kind of crossing your legs. The first one, excuse me, the first one is just cross your leg in this way. You don't need to put it on your. This is the easy posture. In Burmese, we may call it Burmese style. Sukha asana. Sukha means happy. Sukha asana means to sit cross leg like this. Thai people also sit like this when they do some work, and you also get familiar with this thing. The next one, we call it the half lotus. To put your leg on this, on your leg, your leg on your leg, and the half lotus and the full lotus in this way. This is the best posture, because you make the triangle, and it's very balanced. It makes yourself become pyramid, very 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 balanced. If you can sit in this way, it's good. But if you cannot sit, just sit on the sukhasana or Padmasana, half lotus, that's okay. But if you try every day, at the beginning it may have some pain, but later you will feel, get used to it. When you practice every day, you get used to it. This is good because no part of your body, no bone of your body, you touch the ground. If you put it like this, this point will touch the ground. And sometimes you get pain also. So if you sit like this, you sit on the armchair, because you use your what you call, that's nothing. That's only your meat, your skin. So it's like you sit on the armchair, and you carry the armchair with you anywhere you go. If you can sit in this way, you don't need to sit on the armchair. But if you cannot do this, some foreigner, some Falang, or some Westerner who do not used to sit on the floor, at the first time they do this, sometimes some person cry because it's very very pain. So they need some time to practice. And it's also good if you can have some cushion about an inch to sit on, because this will make you more comfortable. You can sit on the chair if you have some problem about your health, your leg, or your back. You can sit on the chair also. But the really important thing is that to keep your back stretch, stretch your back. Because if you stretch your back, the air will flow comfortably. We need the air to flow comfortably. This is very important. And also your stomach, the abdomen will not be pressed, so it also helps. And your spinal nerve will be alert if you sit, stretch your back. If you do not stretch your back, it's not so alert, it's not so awake. So if you just keep your back stretched, it will help a lot at the beginning. And when you practice, please try to check that your back is stretched or not. How you know it's stretched or not? You just keep a deep long breath in. When you first you take the air in, your abdomen will be up. And when you breathe more, the air will come to your lung, and your abdomen will be but not so it will be you come in. And you you take more air. But this way, your back will stretch, and this is the, and then you breathe out, and after that you can breathe normally, naturally. Your shoulder also relax, stretch, and relax. You don't need to do this or do this. It's too much. If you don't know how it's proper, you just keep it back and then put it down. That's also natural. Your head up. Do not keep it in the left side or in the right side or in front or at the back. Because if you practice for a long time, you feel some pain also. So keep your head up, stretch, and you may close your eye or if you want to open your eye, you can. If you feel comfortable to close your eye, and when you close your eye, you feel more concentrated, that you can close your eye gently. Do not have any tension at your eye. But if you close your eye, you fall asleep. Very easy to fall asleep. You should not close your eye. You should open your eye. Or sometimes when you close your eye, you think a lot. You think of somebody, someone's face, right? You think about something when you close your eye. Some people are really have some problem about when you close your eye, you think a lot. So you should not close your eye at this moment because you are not ready. Or sometimes when you close your eye, you feel hot at your eye. Sometimes there's some heat in your eye. So you should open your eye also. But open your eye just half open. You get at your nose. When you get at your nose, look at your nose, you see nothing. You see nothing. That means you do not pay any attention to anything. You see nothing. But the light can come to your eye that help you not so sleepy. The wind can pass through your eye. And you do not think a lot because you can see something. But you cannot identify that thing. You just guess at your nose. Like the Buddha image, you see? The Buddha image is serene. Keep your eye down. You can look on the floor, just a foot or 2 foot before you. But you don't need to look at the floor. You just look, do not focus to anything. You just look, guess at your nose, that's okay. By this way, you can practice meditation. And when you gain concentration, your mind is calm, the eye will close gently, naturally. And you have no problem about think too much or eat anymore. How to put your hand? Most of the master said that you should put it together on your, like this. But you can try another way. Put it on your knee. If you put it on your knee, it is too good reason. The first one is that if you place your knee in this way, your back will stretch more. Small stretch. You stretch your back. And this will help you to be a pillar that make you more balanced and firm. So you can use this way also. If you feel that hot, something hot at your hand, you can change and put this. Or you can start with this posture also. To put your hand on your knee, or put your hand together, it depends. If you do not used to this thing, you may tie and you may get, you may find that it helps you some to stretch your back. In fact, you can put your hand anywhere else. You can put it on the head also. But when you concentrate, it will fall down, right? So it's not proper. So put it anywhere that you do not think about it. You don't want to, you don't need to pay attention for it. So on the knee or on your feet is okay. No problem. Now we will start to prepare the body, the posture already. And the next thing we will start with the prepare our mind, to set our mind. First of all, you should remind yourself about now you will practice meditation. the good benefit from meditation, such as to calm down your mind, to give your mind food, happiness, or develop some virtue, such as mindfulness, concentration, and wisdom. This is very important thing in our life. We cannot get this from buying from anyone else, but we must practice our own. So this is the most important thing we can do to ourselves. And now we will practice meditation. Only thing that we will do is practice meditation. So please forget anything. Forget the past that already passed. Do not keep it in your mind. Forget the future, that the worry about the future, because this may disturb your meditation. But stay in the present moment only. When you set this mind, it will help you to concentrate and stay with the breath. When you set the body and the mind properly, now we start with taking a deep long breath 2 or 3 times. Take the longest breath you can, so that sometimes you have some sound at your nose, and you feel that air touch your nose also. This is good, because if you start with the clear breath, it helps you to follow the breath. At first, it helps you to clear all thinking, all emotion in your mind. You may have something in your mind. If you just pay attention to your breathing, you will forget, or you will breathe away all things, and then follow your breathing in from your nose through your chest and in at your abdomen. When it pauses, you wait a minute. You wait, when it pauses, you know it stops, and when it comes out, you also know it, and follow the breath from the beginning, past your chest at the middle, and then to your nose. When it's finished, you also pause. You know it pause, it stop, and then when it come out again, you just follow this this breath, the breathing. When you breathe in, you know it. Breathe in. When you breathe out, you know it. Breathe out. Breathe out. You don't need to say any word. We use the natural way, natural method, so we do not create any word. And this also very easy if you can just know it move or it stop, it move in or out. And if it's long or short, you just know it is long or short. But at the beginning, we suggest you to breathe long, because if you breathe long, the long breath will calm your body, calm your mind. And this is the good, this is the good thing that we can start now. So please sit comfortably. Balance and firm. Please take a deep long breath in mindfully, and then breathe out mindfully. Follow your breath. Follow your breath slowly, from the beginning, the middle, until the end. If any thoughts, any thinkings arise in your mind, you just know it and let it go, and back return to your breathing again. Breathe in and out again, long, clear, and be mindful at the breathing. Breathing in, relax your body. Any part of your body that have tension, relax it. If you take a long breath, you feel calm and relaxed more. Be mindful of your breathing. Gently. Breathing in, relax. Breathing out, please be mindful. Breathing in, calming. Calming your body, calming your mind. Breathing out, please have a smile on your face. Have a little smile on your face as the Buddha smiles. Mindfully, breathing in, calming, breathing out, smiling. When you smile, you relax your muscle on your face, and that muscle will be relaxed, and you feel warm and friendly, and you can be master of yourself. Gently open your eyes. Please stay with the long breath. If you calm your body and calm your mind, slow down your thinking, slow down your thoughts, and by this way you have calm body and calm mind. If you have this stable, calm and pure mind, cool mind, you gain this more and more when you practice longer and longer when you sit. After that we can use this calm mind to contemplate on the vipassana level. To calm your mind in this way we call it samatha. When you mindful of some things continually, you gain concentration or samadhi. This concentration will be relaxed, gentle. It is not the concentration in someone misunderstand that concentrate means to be tense with something or someone. In the past we may have tension when we concentrate something, but in practice meditation, we practice a bit relaxed. Gentleness. So concentration means you can stay with that things all the time. How can you know that you success in this samatha? You success when you can follow your breathing long continually without any thoughts interfere or distract your mind, disturb your mind. If you can stay with the long breath, this breath will be longer and longer and refined. Until it's so delicate, gentle, until you cannot feel it, and you may think that you do not breathe at all, and some of you may surprise and then frighten that you will die. If you frighten or if you surprise, if you have some doubt in your mind, some thinking alive, your mind will change. The mind you move from concentration, so your breath will be short and will be close. Will be not so defined again. So just know that in fact you still breathe, but you breathe very gentle. And you're still alive, no problem. If the breath calm down until breath is similar, it seems like that you have no breath at all, you just wait, and then when it come out, when you start to breathe again, you can know, you just know it. You don't need to think to have any doubt, any thought, frightened, any surprise. It is normal, it is ordinary, it is natural. You just stay and be gentle. And when the breath starts again, you just come back to your breath. For the people who practice meditation, it may take a very short time to calm down the breath. But if you are the beginner or if you are so busy, it may take you half an hour or 10 minutes or 15 minutes or 20 minutes. It depends on your mind. If your mind have the habit of thinking, talking, what you think, what you talk, what you read will appear here when you practice meditation. So the more you talk, you must pay the price. So if you keep your word, if you keep your, if you try to not to associate with the people, by this way your mind will be easy to calm down. And you will feel that practice meditation is very easy, because when you can stay with the breath, you can appreciate the breath. You are happy, you are calm and gentle. But if you sit and you think a lot, you have some difficulty. And tomorrow we will talk more about difficulty in practice and how to reduce or how to overcome difficulty in your practice. But one thing that we would like to suggest you is try to reduce or stop your, give up your talking, your thinking. Whenever you think, or whenever you know that you want to talk, you just stop it and return to your breathing again. If you try to do this all the time in your daytime, when you want to sit and you come to sit, you can calm your mind, calm your breath very easy. Now this is the very basic method that we will practice. The next we will practice standing meditation. So all of us please stand up slowly, mindfully. Stand up. We can also practice standing meditation. Just stand up. You can hold your hand together in front or behind you. Or you can put it together on your chest as you like. We keep the hand together because it makes us more careful. Your head also up. Keep your head up. Stretch your back. And you can know that you stand balanced or not. If you must try to control your body, that means that is not balanced manner. If you can stand balanced manner, in balance manner, there's no weight at all. Everything is balanced, so it's very, very easy. So learn how to stand from your experience. No one can teach you. No one can tell you. You just learn how to stand relaxed and balanced and firm. You may open your eyes and half, and then look at you in front on the ground for one or two meters in front of you. But do not focus on anything. If you close your eye, sometimes you may feel very difficult to balance your body. So open your eyes. If you have this proper manner, please practice breathing in and out for a while. Breathing in, you know, when it through your chest and in your abdomen, you also know it. When it pause, it stop, you know it. When it come out, you also know it. Breathe the long breath mindfully. Breathing in, calming. Breathing out, smiling. Please relax your body, any part of your body that has tension, please relax it. Put your mind at that part of your body and relax gently. If you cannot feel your breath, you just breathe a long breath, deep and long and clear, one or two times, so that you can catch it, you can know it touch, and then follow the breath in and out. When it moves in, you know it moves in. When it stops, you know it. When it moves out, you also know it. And this standing meditation also useful because it's a point that we will start walking meditation. When you start walking meditation, we start with standing first. So you practice standing meditation, and after that you can practice walking meditation. But now I would like to show a little bit about how to walk naturally. So please mindfully sit down. To practice walking meditation, we can focus our mind into things. If you can observe your breathing in and out while you walk, that's good, because you can stay with the breath all the time. In any action, in any posture, you can stay with the breath. But it's a little bit difficult when you walk and you know the breath move in and out, move and stop. If you cannot know the breath, you can focus your mind to observe the step, the feet, the step that you take the step. When you move the step, you know it. When you touch, when you stop, you know it. When you touch the ground, you know it. When you balance your weight, when you balance yourself, your movement, you also know it. By this way, you can continue to be mindful. We practice standing, walking meditation, this standing meditation. So keep your hand in front or behind you, or you will make a loose palm together. So that you will move your hand. If you walk and move your hand, it's very easy to slip your mind out. But if you keep your hand together, you will focus your mind on the step or on the breath. It will more. It will be easier to focus the mind on just one thing. So you keep your hand. And when you walk, if you walk alone, you take the step for 12 or 15 steps. It should be the ground that you can walk on the field, or on the ground, or on the sand beach. It's not too steep, and you don't need to control yourself much when you walk. You can mark the point when you start here, and when you walk for 12 or 15 steps, you mark another point. You may use your shoe, or you can use some bags of tree or something, some rock to make you know this is the way that you will walk, so that you don't need to think again and again that what should we turn back now or the next step. You don't need to think anything. You just know this is the point that you turn back again. To practice in some area when you walk alone is also helpful, because if you walk the long way, if you walk on the long way, sometimes you walk and you think. You do not know that you think. So to walk on the long way, you continue thinking. But if you walk in the short way, in the some limit, when you turn down, when you turn back, at that point, your thinking will stop, and you will start to observe your breath again, or observe your step again, and it helps you. And sometimes you cannot find the place to walk so long, so you choose some area. Perhaps in your bedroom you can practice also. Even though your bedroom is not so long, not so great, but if you know how to walk, you can practice. If you were put in the prison, in the cell, very limited area, you can also practice this kind of walking meditation. But just know that you turn right one time and the left one time to make you balance. If you just turn right, every time you turn right on the right hand, if you have some limited area, sometimes you may get confused. But if you turn one and another time you turn in a different direction, by this way you have balance. And you will see only one side of the view. Or if you turn in this way, you will see this side. When you turn another way, you also see the same side. So and I would like to show you a little bit how to walk. Sape sata sukita hontu. Sape sata avera hontu.สัพเพสัตตาอัปยาปชาหุนตุสัพเพสัตตาอานิคาหุนตุสัพเพสัตตาสุขีอัตตานังปริหารันตุสัพเพสัตตาสัพพทุกขาปะมุจฉันตุสัพเพสัตตาลัทธะสัมปัตติโตมาวิคัจฉันตุ
สัตเตสตากัมมสตากัมมทายาทากัมมโยนิกัมมปันตุกัมมปฏิสรณายังกัมมังกลิสันติ